So besides questionable haircuts, what do 13th century monks and the EDM producer Skrillex have in common? Well, it turns out that they're both fans of Hocket. No Google, Hocket. It's a compositional technique where melodies and rhythms are redistributed among different instruments. The aim of it is to hear an uninterrupted melody while at the same time retaining all of the individual timbral characteristics of each unique instrument. Let's check out some examples. The term Hocket comes from the Ars Antiqua, or European medieval music, from about the 13th century. The Dirty Projectors is an indie rock band that uses Hocket fairly frequently, and their frontman David Longstreth explains how Hocket was used in the 13th century in this clip.
They did it in like 13th century like monk music at Notre Dame or whatever, where you have the line to a hymn, certain groups of the monks would sing various parts of the melody. It's sort of broken up.
A really cool modern example of Hocket is the a cappella arrangement that Pentatonix did of Daft Punk's Better, Faster, Stronger.
Better, be faster, makes you stronger,
more than
ever, hour after,
never,
work is,
never,
work it harder, better,
it
faster,
better,
stronger,
more than
The technique, though, was developed independently across many different cultures. In Balinese gamelan music, for example, it's called kotikan, where two or more parts will interlock in a kinetic and dizzying array of rhythm. Check it out. This sort of thing requires a phenomenal amount of trust in your fellow musicians, because you all need to be on the same internal clock for it to sound seamless. Because of this, Hocket has kind of been used as this, like, show-off technique at high speeds. Consider this example from Duke Ellington's Braggin' in Brass from 1938. The trombone Hocket is kind of this amazing collective feat of virtuosity. There are more applications of Hocket beyond this, like a virtuoso technique for performing ensembles. It also shows up as a compositional technique in a lot of electronic dance music. Rapid shifts between synthesized textures create a really interesting timbral fabric. Let's check out this, Bangarang by Skrillex. The result of this is kind of like a musical analog to the art movement known as pointillism. Artists like George Seurat painted with thousands and thousands of dots on a canvas. When you look at them up close, they kind of look a little bit disjoint, but when you stand back, they form a satisfying whole. It's kind of a cool term in music that captures this effect, and that term is Klangfarben melody. Germans sometimes have really cool words for things. It means tone color melody, where you think about shifting instrumental colors when you write your melodies. The term is closely associated with 20th century composer Anton Webern, who used it in his orchestral arrangement of the Reisekar from Bach's Art of Fugue. Let's listen to it and pay close attention to how the melodies sort of morph into one another. I hope these examples of Hocket might inspire you and get the creative wheels turning in your own music making, because they certainly did for me when I was checking out all of this stuff. I came up with kind of an interesting workflow and technique for achieving this. First, I'm going to record myself playing a bass line to a drum loop. So now what we're going to do is we're going to convert the audio that we just recorded into MIDI. Unfortunately, Ableton Live has that function of audio to MIDI. It's not great at the conversion, so sometimes we kind of have to clean it up a little bit. If your digital audio workstation doesn't have this functionality, you could conceivably do this technique by hand by individually drawing in all of the MIDI notes from the bass line that you played. From here, we can separate the MIDI clip into several different synths and samplers and other things on different tracks to create kind of this multi-layered instrumental hocket. This is the result of it. I hope you enjoy. Hey everybody, thank you so much for watching. My name is Adam Neely. I have a new video coming out every Monday. If you enjoy what I do, please consider joining my Patreon, because it's through my patrons over at Patreon that I'm able to do this every week. So thank you so much for watching, and until next time, peace!